She's existing as such, much better than that. So at the moment, this is the building that's there on site at the minute. You have all those at the bottom and then the two-story house at the top. So because of the difference in level, because of the nature of the sort of the cliff and the landscape and the edge, you don't have a clear view down into that garden. You're kind of looking across the roof of that property. And that continues to the level as well, so you're still not looking down into the roof or across it. You don't have a line of sight into the roof.
Thank you, Pat.
Okay, Pat.
Stuart, sorry. I was just going to ask for the argument being made seems to be about mass. Well, I was precisely what I was looking to see. It strikes me that there are two rear building lines, in fact, one to the south of the development site and one to the north. It isn't a consistent one. Do we have street team as well? The street team, because the height was also mentioned. Now we've seen that, I think there is consistency with the rear street team, to be perfectly honest. It certainly matches the street team to the south. The effort has been made to, if you like, dot that in to lessen the impact of the rear street team to the north. If we have the street team to the ridge house,
This is the application site of the center and the properties on the other side.
The reason for refusal is that the proposed development would be of a scale which would not relate well to surrounding property and would not provide adequate individual private or communal garden space for each dwelling, contrary to policy HS4 of the Rural Unitary Development Plan. An overdevelopment in conflict with HS4.1 relating to the scale of the building, HS4.2 relating to the character of the area, and HS4.7 relating to adequate garden space.
Okay, we've
had a move.
Is there a seconder? Thanks, Eddie. Okay, so all those in favour of refusal? And those against? Okay, that's lost. So if we move to the substantive motion, is the officer's recommendation is to approve this subjective condition listed and the additional additional provision on the red list, condition tab. Is there a move for this, please?
I'll move that, Chair. I don't think the argument is held by the indication that it's a two-tier planning system, one for Bear.
Okay, I wasn't saying that's really...
One for posh bits, so I'll move it.
Okay, let's not get into that. So do I move it? Denise, you're second to that. All those in favour of approval? And those against? That planning application is carried, thank you. Okay, so we now move on to agenda item 7, which is 34 to 38 Conway Street, Birkenhead, and it's pages 37 to 40 in your packs. Can we have a presentation of the present, please?
Thank you, Chair. This application is referred to the planning committee as its departure from the unitary bank of power. The application site is within a primary commercial area, and the proposed use is sui generis. There's been one objection to this proposal, which can be summarised as this type of use objectifies and sexualises women and will be seen to promote all that is wrong with the male perception of women. The application is for the retention of the use of the premises for the lap dancing club at ground floor level of the premises. The building is located within an area designated as primary commercial within the key town centre of Birkenhead. With regards to planning policy, there's no specific policy for this type of club, but it's considered that the most relevant policy in this instance is HS6, which is development in a primary commercial area, which permits shops, services, food and drink uses subject to certain criteria, which includes uses that do not cause nuisance to neighbouring uses or lead to loss of amenity. The previous use of the premises was a bar, and the change of use from one late night town centre use to another is not considered very detrimental to the character of this part of Birkenhead. A licence to operate the club was granted last year. With regards to the operational hours, the applicant has applied to open between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m, which is half an hour later than the previous use at the drinking club. There are currently no residential properties in close proximity, and given that the site fronts Conway Street within a town centre setting, it's accepted that this is a suitable location for late night use. The external treatment of the frontage has changed little in appearance, a bet being blacked out to prevent views into the premises, and is considered to have little detrimental impact on the character and appearance of the street scene. So it's for these reasons the application is recommended for approval, subject to the attached condition.
Okay, we don't have a petition on this application, so is there a more council would like to speak? Do you want to come forward, please? If you could just state your name for the minute, please. Agenda item 6, we've just discussed that, it was approved. Okay, so if you do want to leave now, you have to do so. Do you need to leave now? Are you happy to stay?
Yes.
Okay, good people here. So I'm Phil Davis, Councillor Phil Davis, ward councillor. So I am here tonight to ask the planning committee to refuse this application. This lap dancing club is in a key area of Birkenhead town centre, where, as I think most of the committee will know, we have, I think, ambitious plans for regeneration, both residential, retail, commercial, in sites adjacent to Conway Street and the location of this proposed lap dancing club. I'm really concerned that should permission be granted, this will make it more difficult, I think, for the council and its partners to present a positive image of this part of Birkenhead town centre, and anybody knows this area will, I'm sure, agree that we need to bring more vitality, vibrancy, and particularly I'd like to see more families living in this part of Birkenhead town centre as they used to many years ago. And I believe if this application is granted, it will make it particularly difficult to attract residential development for families to return to this part of Birkenhead town centre. I'd just say on a personal note, I've spoken to many of my constituents who live not very far away from this club, and I have been struck by the level of opposition from particularly local families who live in this area. They believe that it will be detrimental to the character of this part of the town centre. So, Chair, it's for these reasons I would ask the committee to refuse this application. Thank you.
Clearly, planning committee is not the place, and the planning legislation is quite specific about it. Religious and moral issues are not generally are part of a plan decision. However, it is very difficult for those with a conscience to not put them in. I can assure you that I've put them to one side, and my arguments would be very much along the lines of planning. And again, just to reiterate that, another arm of the council, I believe, the licensing committee, has been that this operation, whatever you want to call it, can be run safely and within the licensing rules that currently exist. So no moral judgment has been made there. However, I think Phil Davis, as Lord Councillor, is quite right. If you actually think of Conway Street and how it's advanced since the demolition of the flyover. The reason we demolished the flyover was to make it a gateway and a main thoroughfare of Birkenhead town centre. And as you know, there have been significant developments in and around Conway Street, and there are still some fairly heavily used municipal buildings in the area. And I think on the grounds of what the growth plan and what the current ambitions are for Birkenhead, that there are legitimate planning reasons, and that's what we're here to discuss, planning reasons to say that this is the wrong type of development in that particular location. I don't know much about these places, but I've never seen one in Liverpool on the main thoroughfare into Liverpool. Never seen one. They tend to be in other locations. So I clearly think that there's a planning statement to be made about what's our ambitions, about the location, and those people will hold those moral judgments for another place to make those decisions. People have written in about the exploitation of women and those issues, but however, I think the grounds are there, and like I've always said, if we are going to move for refusal, then we should have as good a reason for refusal and a defendable reason for refusal that is possible. And I've sought through Chair, new chair and officers, if we were minded that there are reasons for refusal. However, I'm not here for full debate, so as ever, I remain open minded until we hear debate, but I will bottom notice that if we are minded as a committee to refuse, there are valid planning reasons for the refusal.
Okay, thank you.
Lancashire. Representing a West Wirral ward as I do, I suppose one could say I have no views either way on this, but I do believe that as a council member of this council, I am obliged to try to support any regeneration aspects of the whole of the borough, not just worried about my own ward. And my concern here is keep the moral side of it, that is irrelevant from a planning perspective. My view is that this is not an appropriate development to enhance the attempts by the borough to regenerate that area of Birkenhead, particularly as the Councillor Fowkes has said, the approach from Liverpool and from elsewhere on the main road into the borough. So my view is it is a totally inappropriate development to impose on this area. I'm not too concerned about the current residential impact of it, there's nothing residential at the moment within a short distance of it, although we have approved at the last planning committee residences for students, which we're hoping eventually will be built. But that's not the argument. My argument is purely the fact that this is totally inappropriate, and I feel obliged, and we're all West Councillor, but as somebody who thinks strongly about trying to improve the quality of provision in this borough, I think it's totally the wrong sort of development for us to approve. And I'm interested to see what reasons have been put forward for refusal, but provided they are based on planning grounds, I'm inclined to support them. Thank you, Chair.
Yeah, thanks, Chair. Just to add, I suppose, to those previous comments, I did look at kind of some kind of case history around these kind of establishments, and I was struck by one refusal for a similar application in Bristol, which is upheld at appeal. I think it was just interesting to see the reasons that the appeal officer gave for upholding that refusal, which are broadly along the lines that have been discussed here already. Just a quote from her report, she said, "Regeneration, though much dependent on harnessing economic factors, is also determined by social factors and requires local support to be successful. The proposal would not contribute to building a positive and attractive image, introducing uses of general public interest or service to the area as sought in local plan policies. And I conclude that the proposed lap dancing club could have a materially detrimental effect on schemes for continuing regeneration." So there's kind of clear parallels there in what other authorities have refused and what has been upheld at appeal. So that was just really what I wanted to add, and I'm interested to hear what the wording is in terms of refusal.
Okay, if there's no other comments, I'm sorry, Stuart.
Sorry, just very briefly. I just wanted to comment that the report correctly points out that there is no provision in the Usual Development Plan for lap dancing clubs. But then I think, I'm about to say, erroneously goes on then to say, well, there's one that's near enough, which officers have then obviously went to make their judgment and bring a recommendation to us. And, I'm bound to say, possibly in common with other members, I think in comparison with SH6, it is the wrong one. And I think the point made by Phil Davis that regard all means have been made to the growth plan, I think, as Frank's been saying, the growth plan and the regeneration strategy, both of which outline our ambition for the area, and no regard appears to be to either of those aspirations. The regeneration strategy, I think, is adopted by the council for the purposes of guiding our planning considerations. Councillor Fowkes is quite right, it's a whole lot of this because I've been near enough bus stop. The bus station, which is right over the road, and I walk past the health centre, which is again just over the road. And, these are facilities that are open to all members of the community, and I wouldn't wish, we've had representations from residents and from others who have indicated to us that females in particular are uncomfortable with the sort of establishment in the area, and I would not wish females visiting the health centre, getting off the bus, etc. To feel that level of uncomfortable when coming to what is the centre of Birkenhead. For those reasons, please excuse the effort if you like to find the grounds, but as an element policy implications, under this provision, clearly will have to be based, I guess, around the effect on the wider community and on our aspirations for the regeneration of that part of town.
Thanks, Stuart. So I think, Denise, you wanted to say something there.
This has been a nightclub for I was there for my 18, so that's over 35 years ago.
Surely not.
If it doesn't get permission tonight, it will have to be made back to a nightclub because this is a retrospect. So it will not be able to be a rock dancing club. But hopefully, once all the money that's going to be coming into the area and more power to more people, it will be getting used again. And hopefully we'll survive the bad patch that Dan Beckenham is going through. I mean, we need these little businesses, we need these nightclubs, because we just do have to go out for 9 seconds. But, I mean, I'll probably be going with refusal tonight, because it's not, I think, not for what we want to do in the future in Beckenham.
Thanks,
Denise.
Can we go back to Steve then, you can move refusal?
Obviously, there have been some really encouraging announcements about Beckenham Town Centre, and I think the idea was redeveloping and reinventing that it is beginning to take shape. We had the student accommodation, we had a withdrawal application directly opposite of residential, and the recent announcements of the nursing students coming into Old Market House again. To be able to decide that, I would hate also to have given application permission that would discourage that type of development, they're the type of developments that we're looking for. So, the reasons for refusal are the continued use as a lap dancing club on a primary commercial frontage constitutes a development which does not promote a positive image of the area and would be in conflict with the council's proposals for regeneration and vitality and the vitality of Birkenhead Town Centre, including any future residential proposals, and is thereby contrary to Unitary Development Plan Policy SH1 criteria for development in key town centres and our former new venture.
Okay, thank you, Stuart. All those in favour of refusal? That's unanimous. To agenda item 8, which is planning appeals decided between the 1st of February and the 31st of March. This item is for Linton. Would you be happy to know that? Thank you. Agenda item 9 is planning applications decided on the delegated powers between the 12th of March and the 19th of April 2018. Are you happy to know those?
Yes.
Okay, well that actually concludes our agenda for this evening. This being the final meeting of the municipal year, I would like to thank our solicitor, minute clerk and officers for their support throughout the year.
Yeah.
I'd also like to thank members for their contribution and support throughout the year. In particular, I'd like to thank Denise Reilly, Trina Johnson and Eddie Bullitt for their services, not only to the planning committee, but to the council in general. And I wish you the best of luck in whatever life brings you next. Okay, so with that, I'll just conclude closing the meeting. Okay, thank you very much.
Yeah. I'll just comment that, again, thank you for chairing the meeting so well and so constructively. And thank you to the officers for all support for giving us all.
Just to set your hand, the chair of planning commission is probably one of the most difficult roles in the authority. And planning committee is one of the ones where you're either a hero or a villain. I think I've done a great job.